Proud kombucha mom.
So, I wanted to do something special to wrap up my first tutorial series. Thank you so much if you followed it and said something nice about it. It really means the world. I believe in not speaking negatively of your own work, like publicly online. Because, you know, like, you're always going to be your own worst critic, and also no one else is going to sell your work for you, and you need to sell yourself and just own what you make and be proud of it. That being said, last week the self-conscious feelings were so strong, and so all of the comments, all of your support, and the incredibly warm welcome from the Blender community, it continues to blow me away and to mean so much to me. So thank you. But without further ado, let's get excited about Grease Pencil for the next 10 minutes. Today, I want to share all the different ways that I used this one horse skeleton, like the one that we made in the tutorial series. Because I used it in that Breath of the Wild fan art that I shared, but I also got 14 other illustrations from it. And that's something that really excites me about Blender and Grease Pencil as an illustrator. Of course, you can't print a 3D painting unless you're a wizard. But I think that there are still so many exciting possibilities with Blender and ways that you can repurpose your 3D art and reuse your assets for traditional 2D printing. So one of my secret hobbies is collaging. And so I just wanted to make a cool collage page that I could print out at home and cut out and have fun collaging with. And so if you'd like to print some out yourself, I did make it a listing on my Gumroad page. I'm really proud of how they turned out, and you would be supporting this channel and me, and it would mean a lot. So here is the first file that I started fixing up. Like the Breath of the Wild fan art page, it has a rearing animation, and I did this just by playing back a YouTube video of a horse at like 0.25 speed and taking a bunch of screenshots and just trying to recreate those poses using the horse rig. Also, you can see that I'm using my rainbow line art brush, which I talked about in my first ever YouTube video. And so the ribcage will get this modifier eventually, but all of the other Grease Pencil objects have a tint modifier on them, and this just makes so that all the strokes have a blue to a purple magenta color. Also, I didn't feel quite ready to explain this in the tutorial, but basically I animated the tail using the sculpt tools, just moving it around. And then in the timeline, you can see that these white keyframes are where I actually manually sculpted it. And then the blue keyframes in between were done in edit mode using the interpolation tool to get Blender to animate for me between the two keyframes that I created. Version 2. Also, speaking of having different versions, I got this awesome comment on my last video where, you know, I was going through all 20 plus versions of my newest piece, explaining that you can get Blender to add a new number for you just by hitting Ctrl+Shift+S, and you can press this plus icon next to the name of your document. So I got rid of the rearing animation, and I just kept some poses that I really liked. Some of them are from the rearing animation, and some are just from photos that I found online. And then this horse is getting swarmed by the paparazzi. So I'm also starting to think about the layout of all of these different illustrations. And so I'm setting up these different cameras to go along with a different pose each. So camera 1 is for the pose on frame 1, camera 2 for the pose on frame 2, etc. And I can look through a specific camera by selecting it, either in the 3D viewport or the scene collection. And then I can just hit Control Numpad 0. And I will be looking at my scene from that camera. So now we have all 7 poses ready to go and all 7 cameras set up to look at them. I also animated the tail for each pose. So this is just, again, using the sculpt tool. And I didn't interpolate them this time because I just wanted a static pose for the tail that felt like it would make sense for that horse pose. So in this version, I've actually applied the animation to the grease pencil objects. So whereas before they were just parented to the rig, now you can see in the dope sheet, they each have a separate keyframe for each pose. So if I go back to my previous version, I can show you I did this by selecting each grease pencil object. And then while I'm in object mode, I go into object up here, go into animation, and then select bake action. And then the only things you want to change is you want to check the box that says visual keying. And you also want to check the box that says clear parents so that the grease pencil object is no longer parented to the rig. And then if we press OK, we now have keyframes in our dope sheet. What was keyframed is the location and rotation of these grease pencil objects. So you can see that if you follow the origin, the yellow dot, as it moves around. And you could also see that in the item transforms if I go here. So we can see that it's the grease pencil object itself that is being keyframed and animated. So I remember that I really wanted to find a way to turn these dope sheet item transform poses keyframes into their own keyframes in the grease pencil timeline, but I couldn't for the life of me figure it out. So here is where having those grease pencil keyframes would have really come in handy. So I knew I wanted the different illustrations to have some different colors, so I could very easily do this with the tint modifier. But the problem was if I wanted to make a change to one of the modifiers, I didn't want to also have to make the change to the modifier in each of my 24 other grease pencil objects. In my skeleton tutorial, someone also shared with me a way to share modifiers between objects, which I have not had a chance to try out myself yet, but sounds like absolute magic. And so what I did for this version was slightly tedious. I basically went one frame at a time. I made a duplicate of each bone. I pressed Ctrl A to apply the item transforms, and then I moved all of the grease pencil bones into a single grease pencil object, one for each pose. So now we have 7 cameras, 7 poses, and 4 tint modifier colors. So I also started exporting them at this point. And in Procreate, I started to move them around and seeing how I could place them. And also seeing, you know, where are the areas where I could squeeze in some 2D illustrations, because I also wanted to do these in Blender with grease pencil. So here, we're really starting to see the illustrations come together. So I've created a new 2D grease pencil object to go with each frame. So these are also done with my rainbow line art brush, and they're all going to have the same tint modifier as their partner 3D object. It's just some of them haven't been applied yet. And so I also used this chance with the 2D layers to clean up the 3D skeletons a bit. I have a layer you can see for skeleton cleanup. And then if I go into 3D space, you can see that these layers are very close to the camera and they were drawn at the origin. And so I moved the origin of the grease pencil object close to the camera, and the drawing plane is view, so that they would be on a flat plane when I would hit numpad 0 and look through my camera. And I also turned on the canvas by going into the grease pencil object, into object data properties, and then I can scroll down, and then in viewport display and in canvas, I can just edit how the canvas will show up. And then if I want to make the canvas visible, I can do that up here in the overlays and check the box for the canvas. So now they're all being finalized and I'm getting ready to put them together. So in output properties here, I have them set to be quite large. And then in order to get a transparent background, I export them as a PNG and I also make the color mode RGBA. This stumped me for a little while. So if you have it just at RGB, you will not get that transparent PNG background. You need to be in RGBA. Apparently the A stands for invisible background. I also have a holdout material on my meshes. And so this window is set to the image editor, just so that when I hit F12 and render my image, it shows up here. So I was using this more when I was doing test renders at a smaller render size. So you may be thinking, Sophie, I can count, and 7 is not 10 plus. Ya clickbaiter. Well, I was also able to make a coloring page version of this collage sheet very quickly, just with the magic of grease pencil modifiers. And so I removed the watercolor layers, and then in the modifiers, I added a tint modifier with the color that was just pure black and the strength at 1. And then I also added a thickness modifier with a thickness factor of 0.6, just because I felt like thinner lines fit better for a coloring page. So for this week's video, I wanted to give a shout out to Suzanne. I am so in love with the grease pencil art and the little animations that she's been making. And she also shares these little making of videos. And when she told me that this piece was made with grease pencil, my brain could literally not understand how. And so recently I saw this process video she took. It's just stunning. It blows me away, truly. How? And so I definitely recommend that you check out her art. I'll link her social medias down below. And I love it. I love seeing how different artists are using grease pencil. And I love that so many of us are getting converted to the blender side. I love it. I love it. Check out Suzanne's art. Oh. So that is how I got with this one horse skeleton grease pencil drawing. Not just this 3D Breath of the Wild fan art piece, but also 2 collage pages, a colored version and a coloring page version. I have the horse skeleton at 7 different angles, 7 different poses, and I never had to redraw a single part of it. So I hope that this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Liking and subscribing is a big help to this channel, so you can find me on all of the social medias at Sophie Jantak, and I will see you very soon. Bye. Just because I felt that thinner... Oh no! Fudge me!